Congenital scoliosis is a spine deformity that is present at birth. And it's present at birth because there has been either a defect in formation of a vertebral body, or there is a defect in the segmentation between the vertebral bodies. So in other words, a part either didn't get formed properly at all, or the parts that were formed never separated into separate vertebral bodies. Some of the vertebral anomalies are limited to a very small segment of the spine. A very common one is a hemivertebra, which is only half the vertebra forms, so that on one side there is a formed vertebra, one side of the spine, and on the other side there's nothing. So that it's easy to see how a curve can form when there is this type of defect of formation. Other types of congenital curves involve a much longer segment of the spine. And here, local limited treatment will tend to not work because there is much more of the spine that is involved. The cause of this is unknown. There is no reason for the parents to consider genetic testing in order to decide if other children in the future might be affected. In general, the congenital scoliosis means that there will be some form of growth disturbance, but the severity of that growth disturbance varies all over the map. From being something that never requires treatment and observation only, to something that requires early intervention because we must grow the spine in order to avoid the detrimental effects that it will have on the child's overall growth and pulmonary function.